Welcome back, everybody. It's time for Ask the Expert. Thom's here from Nutri-Lawn today, and we're going to have a good time. We're going to entertain your questions. We're going to answer those questions because this is the time of year you should ask questions about your lawn and what to do with it. I have the answer, and that's call Nutri-Lawn.
And that's a good answer.
And get them to come out.
That's a great answer.
But people want to manage their lawns. They want to look after things as much as they can, I'm sure.
Yeah, absolutely.
Some people are good at it. Some people should immediately call your number.
Absolutely.
Right?
Buy a house, call us before you call anybody else.
That's yeah. Right. We're starting this week is going to be nice the rest of the week, okay? Yeah. So this is the time of year when things really start ramping up for your lawn.
This is the time that you want to get your seeding done. This is the time when you want to get your aeration done. Start to get on the raking on the lawn.
But right.
You know, things like equipment like this will drop seed into your lawn, put little slits into it to make sure that the seed goes down to where the soil is. Works really, really well.
Yeah.
Great time to get this done. With the aeration, you know, the first thing farmers do in the springtime is they open up their soil.
Yeah.
And it's exactly what we do as well. We get in there with the aeration, put some overseeding down with that as well.
Yeah.
And you get fantastic rates.
A lot of people think this is the sort of thing that only happens in the fall, but that's not true at all.
Not at all. No, this is the best time to get seeding done because you want to get maximum growth. Yeah. You got maximum growth this time of year.
So when you aerate, what does it do?
Aeration, what it does is these tines actually go into the soil.
Yeah.
And you can see this is a professional quality aerator, and what this, look how deep these tines are. They're 4 or 5 inches deep.
Right.
They go in, they pull cores out, and as the cores come out, the food and the seed and the water gets into where they were, which allows for maximum germination.
Okay. Okay, so you're not actually going around dropping seed into these little holes.
No.
It just happens.
We will broadcast spread after it with this type of equipment here.
Right.
This is good for minor repairs. If you have just a couple of spots in the lawn about the size of your fist, this is a great piece of equipment to do that and do an overseeding.
Gotcha.
This one here would be for a grub damage or drought renovation. A lot of people's lawn died from the drought last year, and this will fix that.
Actually, I've seen it at a couple golf courses already where they've had major problems because of that drought, right?
And absolutely.
The recovery, it may look good at the end of last year, but it's a long-standing thing. It doesn't, you know, just...
Well, the lawns were still weak. And they needed help, and so we need some new varieties of seed to get in there and to help that out as well.
I went, Thom, I went out the other day with my handy rake, just like that one.
Yep.
I put my gloves on the other day. I didn't rake too hard. I kind of went nice and light because I was a little worried about the damage, the further damage I would do. And
on
noticed...
On your hands or your lawn?
No, my lawn. mostly what I did was pick up debris and got some rocks off there and so on. What should people be doing right now?
Well, right now the lawns are pretty much dry enough that they can get on. You want to get just an easy fan rake on it though. You're just going to take that top material off. But this is going to just help get the dead material away from the lawn. But more importantly right now, you have to protect yourself. And we hear about people all the time that end up with huge calluses on their, or blisters on their hand, and it's a problem. So make sure you're putting on good quality gloves, then get yourself a fan rake and get out there and enjoy the afternoon.
They're very stylish and match my shirt.
They are, yes.
I like that. Yeah,
I'm glad we called you this morning to coordinate that.
Yeah, to coordinate your glove choice with what you're wearing.
Yeah.
So get out there and rake up a little bit.
Yeah.
Get rid of some of the debris and the dead stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, next thing you want to do, you want to make sure you get some fertilizer down, so get a program going of some sort, because you have to have 4 or 5 applications.
I'm afraid of fertilizer.
Then you can call people like us, and you don't have to be, because we can apply it. And we have the balanced fertilizer for the season. We're doing the right thing at the right time for you. You don't have to worry about picking the right one.
So, yeah, it's difficult for the layman, seriously, to go into any place where you buy lawn fertilizer and so on and look at it and go, what do all those numbers mean?
Right.
Which one should I be using for my lawn? At what time of year? I mean, I've seen everything from spring fertilizer to summer fertilizer to fall fertilizer, but I know not.
Well, and when you're buying it, you don't know what the weather's going to be. We are buying in such bulk, we can forecast what things are going to happen. We can bring more in at the right time. So we're putting precisely the right fertilizer down for the right time. You're getting the right nutrients all the time. But there's a couple other things people can do this time of year as well.
Okay.
And that's get that lawnmower out, get your blade sharpened. Really important thing. All of our program customers get a free blade sharpening just to make sure they get that done. Another thing they can do is any of those spots that are on the lawn, get the seeding done, just a little spot seeding to help out. And the undercarriage of the lawnmower needs to be cleaned out. If you don't get rid of all that crap and the mold from the winter from it just sitting there, that can cause problems.
If you didn't clean your lawnmower when you put it away for the winter, you're going to notice some mold on the grass that's stuck in there, right?
And it's not going to cut very well.
And it's not going to mulch very well.
Once a year sharpening, basically?
Once a year is good, unless you have a stone lawn and you're...
Huge lawn, right?
Yeah, absolutely. The more you use it, the more you should be sharpening. But once a year generally is very, very good. And the final thing that people need to do when they're doing all this, when they're doing their blade, they're doing their undercarriage, now raise the lawnmower so that the lowest you're cutting your lawn is 2.5 inches. Never cut below 2.5 inches. Yeah, here we go. You cannot have a golf green on your lawn.
You can't
do that. Okay.
Unless you're really, really good at it.
Yeah.
See, that's another common issue. People want to cut so close and they lower that lawnmower and they're really doing more damage than good.
Well, they are. And what's going to happen with that, when they cut it short like that, if your lawn is only this high, your roots are that high. And if your roots are that high, this first hot day that comes out, the top section's going to dry out, the roots are going to dry out, your lawn is going to die.
Okay, people. You know the problems you have with your lawn. Now it's time to get some solutions by giving us a call.
Yep.
613-789-6559, extension 2803. Call that number right now. We'll put you on the air and you can ask Thom a question directly. You can email us questions, Facebook us questions. And if you want to get in touch with Nutri-Lawn, I bet you there's a lot of people going, yeah, I might as well just call them. You can do that. Here's the information on how to do that. Get in touch with Nutri-Lawn and find out more about what they can do for you. More of Ask the Expert with Nutri-Lawn coming right up. We'll be right back.